the spiel with Angie and Julie in another trip on a bus, on a great big bus, an artist bus. We're here today with Tyler Farr. How are you?
This is not our bus.
I know. See, y'all been frequenting buses.
We have. We're bus
hoppers. What do you think about that?
Who was the last bus you've been on?
Joe Nichols.
One of your buddies.
Ronnie Millsap.
And Joe Nichols.
Me and Ronnie Millsap haven't hung out for quite a few years.
You need to. Yeah. You need
cool
to.
Guy.
We lost out of touch many years ago.
You're a stranger in his house. How about that?
I'm Jason Pinkston, and this is your Backstage Pass. Today on Backstage Pass, we catch a ride on the tour bus with Tyler Farr.
You know you broke the wrong heart, baby, and drove me redneck crazy.
You're a Midwest boy, I guess, raised in Missouri.
Yes, sir.
Would you say that helped to form who you are as an artist, or where did that come from?
Yeah, you know, I mean, I grew up in a town about, when I was there, it was about 900 people to 1,000, give or take, but it was rural Missouri.
Okay.
I mean, pretty much right in the center of the state, a little bit south, in the middle of the United States. So it was a, you know, heartland, if you call it, and there was, all they did was raise cattle, corn crops, and that was it. I think they paved our high school parking lot about 3 years ago.
I remember a guy
used to combine in the morning and park it in the parking lot.
How about that?
And then go to school. So it was a pretty rural community. And when you're writing country songs, I mean, I don't know what everybody else does, but I write about stuff from that I know about. If I don't know anything about vacuums, I'm not going to be a vacuum salesman.
Well, who made you redneck crazy then? You're going to name
that one? No. I don't mess with the women. They get get redneck crazy. that song I actually didn't write. A lot of people think I wrote it, so apparently a lot of people think I'm crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. How about that?
Makes me feel really good.
How about that?
Went to Missouri State?
I did.
On a vocal scholarship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can't you tell from the purity of my voice?
You know what? A little opera.
Yeah,
wow.
I did classical music for years. My mom, that's not something when you're a little kid, you're like, oh, I can't wait to sing classical music. My mom got me into that when I was in about the seventh grade. And, I just liked singing, you know, whatever it was. I used to listen to R&B, rap, to rock, Metallica, to whole punk rock wave, and my mom ended up marrying George Jones. And,
yeah, so you spent summers on the bus traveling all over the place with George Jones.
I did. I spent a summer out there with him and babysit him and Nancy's grandkids.
Did you teach him some opera?
No,
I
didn't know a whole lot who the possum was, which for y'all that's not familiar with the possum, bless your hearts.
That's right.
It's George Jones. But young whippersnappers, it's George Jones. But I had no idea who he was. I mean, I knew who he was, but I didn't really know who he was.
Yeah.
And I went out for a summer and remember seeing him by the stage every night and watching him sing and seeing Who's Gonna Fill Those Shoes and flashing pictures of Elvis and Letty Frizzell and Garth Brooks and the new ones, Tim McGraw, Chesney. This was about the year 2000. I graduated high school in 2002. And it was a very pivotal moment in my life.
I have to tell you, I got a kick out of your video, Redneck Crazy. You brought your buds out, but you know, with the Duck Commander being present and Willie was on site, and I asked you, I said, how'd you negotiate that deal? And it really just comes down to a friendship.
Yeah, the president of Sony Records called me and he said, how in the hell did you get Willie Robertson on your videos? Called him.
There you go.
And asked him to be in the video. That's what you do, I think.
Yeah.
Right. That's what I did. I don't know. Colt Ford's been one of my best friends for years. Lee Bryce, one of my dear friends. And Willie, I've known for 6 years through the outdoor industry. I've actually worked in the outdoor industry, did some stuff, and wrote some songs for some shows, and met Willie doing that. And we kind of ran in the same crowd. Luke Bryan, he's mutual friends with him. And
mm-hmm.
Now I'm good friends with Jason Aldean. Been on tour with him all year, and so it's crazy how things kind of.
It wasn't just in your video, man. You guys did one heck of a TP job, and you know the toilet paper flying everywhere. You were getting You were getting redneck crazy.
Yeah, you know. Well, people took a little bit over the top. some people were like, "Oh, this is just so." I'm like, "Calm down. Let's knock it down a notch here. It's music. This is not a documentary.
That's right.
And we're throwing them at their shadows." Yeah. And they're empty beer cans. They're not full frozen beer cans.
Yeah.
Those you can throw a lot harder.
Empty beer cans blow their shadows.
It's got some of the responses I've got from that song have just been overwhelming.
Yeah.
Some of them funny, and the craziest ones have been from women.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we're crazy. You know that.
What? What are you talking about?
You know we are.
I have no idea what you're talking about. You know, every day I can wake up and play country music for a living and get paid to do what I love is a good day for me. I take it one day at a time and try to put out music that's real.
You've gone and broke the wrong heart, baby.
Well, Redneck Crazy obviously was our big song. Whiskey My Water, I think it just went number 9, so it'll be our second top 10 this week.
Every day I pray, I thank God, I got her. She's a moon in my shine, the whiskey in my water.
That's awesome. Congratulations.
And that, thank you. And I did write Whiskey in My Water, and that was kind of a country boy love song, in a way of saying, you're the best thing since the honey bun, you know.
I love that. With butter on top, in the oven.
You've had one.
That's right, apparently. Baby.
She's had number ones, yeah.
And then, on the album, we got Cowgirl. Yes.
Who is she?
It was. I didn't write Cowgirl.
Okay. When you sing it, you think
I think of what every guy thinks of, which is like your ultimate dream woman.
Which is what?
Blonde,
for you.
Brunette,
redhead. She's fishing right now.
I'm just curious, blonde, brunette, what's yours?
You're really throwing a treble hook out in the pond water, aren't you?
She did.
Girls want to know, Tyler.
Well, it's...
Maybe he doesn't discriminate.
I've dated a redhead, I've dated a blonde, I've dated a brunette. The redhead she was a fireball.
She's a fiery one. Yeah.
Yes.
And the blondes, what do you think about the blondes?
And nothing, again, she's someone else's problem now, but she was nothing about you. But
yeah.
Sure.
Oh, she's someone else's problem now.
Oh, that's a good song.
How about that?
We'll write it later.
Yeah.
All right. She's someone else's problem now.
I'm just saying.
By Tyler Farr. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Y'all trying to get a third?
Yes. Hey.
No, but Cowgirl was about, we sing drinking songs, we sing breakup songs, we sing all kinds of songs, but at the end of the day, everybody wants a good woman, which nowadays... At the end of the day.
When I'm done fishing, when I'm done...
When we're done doing all that stuff.
At the end of the day.
At the end of the day. Whoops, sorry, ladies. If we want a girl that has a good heart and a good woman, then there's a... not a ton of them left nowadays.
It's true.
It's sad. I mean, there are some, but it seems like they're hard to come by. So when you get one, you got to hold on to them.
Exactly.
There's a fun fact for you guys. I'm excited to see what this year brings, this next year, and looking forward to the rest of these dates with my new friend, Jason Aldean of Florida Georgia Line. It's going to be heck of a fall.
Hey, we like to end our interview with a fun four. Four things gonna be shot at you, and you
more
tell. There's no.
What caliber?
Pizza or steak?
Steak.
Crunchy or creamy?
Wait, I got a question. Rare or well done?
Rare.
Yeah. Crunchy or creamy?
Crunchy.
George Jones or Haggard?
Both.
No. Both.
Oh,
good.
Boxers or briefs, Tyler?
I know, it's ridiculous. I'm embarrassed that she asks these things.
I don't think I'll boxer briefs.
Is that what you hear?
You mentioned moving into a new house, and we're trying, the spiel is going to start this whole cribs thing, so we're going to come hang if that's okay. Make sure Willie's there, too.
Yeah. I'll set it up for you. It's unlisted. It's not under my name. So
it's not?
You can't find it in the yellow pages.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll be waiting for the invite.
You'll get an invitation in the mail. It'll be a secret, maybe a carrier pigeon.
Yeah.
I'm Jason Pinkston, and this has been your Backstage Pass.